Hey everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to combine two lists as well as remove the duplicates from the list in Python. So I'll be showing you two ways how you can do this. So let's get started. So first we need to combine the list. So for combining the list, it's so simple. We'll be just using the plus operator. So let L3 be my resultant list equal to L1 plus L2. So simple. So if I just now print L3, I'm saving it and running it now. So here you can see both the lists have now combined. So now I will be showing you two ways how you can remove all the duplicate values from it. So the first way I will be showing you with the help of the set inbuilt function. So it's going to be L3 or the resultant variable equal to list. I'll just go with set, all right, set of L3. And if I just now print L3 again, I'm saving it and running it now. So here you can see all the duplicate values have now removed. We had like 4 occurring tries and 3 occurring tries as well, but here you can see now everything is occurring only once. But the issue is that it is of the form set. So for changing that, you can just add this set inbuilt function within the list function. So this will basically convert the set to a list. So set has this property of removing all the duplicates. It doesn't allow any duplicate in it. So that's the reason why we are able to remove the duplicates. So I'm saving it now. So here you can see I've got the resultant list without any duplicates. But the only issue with this method is that we have got a list that is like kind of sorted. So here you can see at the list L1, we had 4, 3, 2. 4 and 3 are duplicates and 1 is occurring only once. And 2, 3, 4 are again duplicates and minus 5 and 0. So the resultant list should have been 4, 3, 2, 1, minus 5 and 0. But the order is kind of changed. You can see, right, it is like sorted in this way and minus 5 is like occurring separately. So this is like kind of sorted. And what if we wanted the order to be maintained, like I said earlier, right, 4, 3, 2 and 1, minus 5, 0. So if you want in the exact same order, you need to follow this second method that I'm going to show. So let me just now close it, and remove this as well. Let me have the resultant combined list as L3 over here. So for this, we will be using the standard way of removing duplicate elements from the list. So for that, let me have a result list, empty result list. So let me call it result equal to empty list. This list will basically contain the combined values of L1 and L2, but without duplicates. So we will be having a for loop for I in L3. So this for loop will basically iterate through all the elements present in our combined list L3. And we will have a if condition as well, if I not in result. So this will basically check if our I, which corresponds to the elements, these elements, if it is not in our result list, then we will are going to just add that particular I to our result list. So it's going to be result dot append I. That's it. If I just now go to the next line and print result, which is my result list. I'm saving it and running it now. So this time we will be getting in the exact same order. So here you can see, right, 4, 3, 2, 1, minus 5 and 0. And you can see the duplicates are as well removed. So now let me show you how this basically works. So our resultant list would be something like this. So let me just now copy it. So this is going to be our L3. So it will have like these values. So these are the values that are going to be in our resultant list L3. So after that, at first our result will be empty. So it will check for I in L3. So initially I will be equal to 4, and if I not in result, so initially our result is empty. So in this case, our result will be equal to 4, because after this particular line, result dot append I, since our I, it is in present in result, this particular I element, which is 4, will be getting appended to result. So our result will be 4. And next, exactly the same thing, from 4 it will go to 3. 3 is not present in result because only 4 is there, will be added. And next, 2 is also not present, so 2 will be added. And next it will go for 4 again. So 4 is already present in result, so this condition is basically false, so it won't go inside that. For 3 also it won't go, and for 1 it will go, and it just goes on. So it's like at the end we'll be getting this as our resultant, like with the duplicates removed. So this is how it works, and I hope you would have found this video useful. I've also done many other videos in Python, C, C++, Java, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL. So do check other videos of my channel. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.